Hey guys, Salty Mario, welcome back to another video. Today, I want to show you how to get custom skins on Minecraft Nintendo 3DS Edition. Before we start, you are going to need Luma custom firmware. You should have God mode with that. God mode 9 should have came with it when you installed it. If you don't have custom firmware, I'll link in the description. I'll put links to a few videos in the description, some decent videos. You also need, you should have plenty of space on your SD card for your 3DS. Of course, you need 3DS as well. And you need Minecraft. And you also need to update Minecraft. And one more thing is, for whatever reason, they don't have a European version of the game. So if you live in Europe, you probably, and if you're watching this, you probably have the US version installed. So, or something like that, I don't know. But there is no official European version. So anyway, what you want to do is first go in the description and download Ohana 3DS. Then it should just download. Then what you want to do is extract it anywhere. Extract it to the downloads. After that, feel free to not create a shortcut. Feel free to delete it. Then what you want to do is just leave this here, and you want to go on your custom firmware 3DS. Okay, so now once you've downloaded that, you want to go on your 3DS and with custom firmware, and so turn it on and hold the start button to load, to start up God mode 9. Sometimes it likes to load glitched, but whatever. Hang on real quick. Okay, so you probably can't see anything. No, you can't, but you also have to look at your own screen. So what you want to do is go to sysnand.sd, go to tile, and go to 0004000E, and then if you're in US, or if you have the US version, go Wi-Fi. You want to go into 001B8700. If you're in Japan, I'll have the where you go in the subtitles. And then you go to content, and then there will be numbers.app. It should just be the first one. Press A. Then it'll give you things. So you want to, on the bottom screen, you want to select NCCH image options. And then you want to go to mount to image to drive. It'll ask you if you are you sure, and you'll say, just click yes. And then once you've done that, you should have EXEFS and stuff like this. So then what you want to do is hover over ROMFS, which should be the second one. And so you want to press R and A at the same time, and you should get G:ROMFS on the bottom screen, pretending it's not blurry. And you want to go to copy to GM9 out, which is the bottom option. Press A, and then it'll start doing stuff. Although this stuff will take a while, so just wait and it'll eventually be done. Okay, so then once it is done, I think I'll just say done, just press A, and then go ahead and just press the power button, right? Oh no, press the home button, and then just it'll bring up this, and just press power off system, or if it just brought you the home menu, just turn it off, and then go ahead and put your SD card in your computer or access the files, however you do it. Okay, so once that's done, go ahead and put your 3DS SD card in your computer. I recommend you put it in your computer, and obviously that's the only thing you can do for old 3DS, but if you're using a new 3DS, I do recommend unscrewing the back and putting it in your computer, because this takes a while, and it'll take even longer through your Wi-Fi, especially if your Wi-Fi is bad like mine. So what you want to do is go to your SD card, and then go to GM9 and go to out, and you should see ROMFS. Go ahead and cut, and then go back to this, or anywhere really. I'm just going back to here because for simplistic sake, but you can put it on a desktop or even make a specific folder for like extracted games if you wanted. So I'll be right back. Okay, so when that's done, just go ahead and go inside, and you should see a bunch of file folders. Where you want to go is ROMFS resource packs, skins, and skin packs. And then there'll be a bunch of skin packs. Some of you who've played the game may also notice that some of these aren't even in there, like this one and this one, which isn't actually like the best one of these ones, but the ones that they do have is this one, and this one. Wait, do they have this change? Yeah, this one, but that's it. All the rest are just there to waste space. But, so what you want to do is pick one of those. I recommend PvP Warriors, because that one has no 3D models. And you can't edit the 3D models, as far as I'm aware, unfortunately. But there are other ones, like Festive also, as well. Biome Settlers 2. And base is just Alex and Steve. You could do multiple, but I'm going to do just one, PvP Warriors. Now, if you want to do an Alex skin, you do want him to have Slim after it, the name. And ones that don't have Slim are Steve model. I'm going to do one that's Steve model. So I'm just going to get one of these. I'm going to get Tundra Stray, I guess. Copy it. Actually, you don't even have to copy it. So don't copy it, just go back to this. You may notice this here, I just got the skin earlier. Go ahead and open up Ohana 3DS Rebirth.exe. Okay, sorry about that. Just so you know, the download for Ohana won't be down to Dropbox. Found the wrong download. Anyway, without wasting time. So, when you've copied, when you've got, open up, oh, God damn, I'm such an idiot. Okay, so open, and go to the one you are intending to download. Let me just go and do that again. What the hell is it doing here? Okay. So, Ohana. 3DS. Go to ROMFS. Resource packs, I've already explained this all, but I guess I have to do it again. I can't actually take stuff out. Actually, I might be able to. In which case, I'll be... Second, okay, go on. PvP Warriors, and so I went with Stray. Open that, and you'll see an upside down skin. So what you want to do is go get your skin, make it, download it, whatever with it, edit it. And once you do that, you want to edit it in paint.net. Don't edit it in MS Paint, seriously. Otherwise we'll go wrong. So go to image and flip vertical and just save. Then you go ahead and close it. It'll be upside down. And so oops. Go to this again. Go to replace. And then go back to where that skin is. And then just replace it. Go ahead and save. By the way, I'm not sure if this works with custom skin. I'm not sure if it works with HD skins. You'll have to test that for yourself. But anyway, once you've done that, go ahead and go to the directory I've said to where the one you replaced is. For me, it'd be Tundra Stray .3dst. Go ahead and copy it, and then go to your SD card, go into Luma, create a folder called Titles if you don't already have one, and then so you want to create a new folder, and you want it to be the Minecraft's title ID, So, I'm not sure it is, so I'll be right back again. Okay, so for US, it is 0004000000. That's 6 zeros. 1B, make sure all the letters are uppercase. 87. For Japan, I'm not sure. Turn on subtitles and I'll be right there. Make sure all generators off. Then go in there, and so you need to create a folder. Name it ROM, FS. All of these will be in the subtitles as well. Create another folder in here, and then name it Resource Packs. And then so you need to create another folder in here called Skins. And create another folder called Skin Packs. Like that. And then in here, whichever one you took it from, you want to name it. So I got it from PvP Warriors. So I'll go ahead and create that folder. Just like it is on this one. Yep. Go in it and then just right click and then paste in the one that you just edited. There we go. And then once that's done, go ahead and just eject your SD card and put it back in your 3DS. Okay, so now once you have done that and put your SD card back in your 3DS, go ahead and turn on and hold the start button. Oh crap, no, the select button to load up the Luma configuration menu. Hang on, my thing has to reboot because I load up the wrong thing. But so you turn on your 3DS and hold select to load up the Luma configuration menu. This. But I can't see. But you want to go down to the option that says enable game patching. It's not sure which one down it is. It is the third one down. Make sure it's enabled. So make sure there's an X before it. No, it's wrong screen. Make sure there's an X before it. And then when you've turned it on, press start to reboot your 3DS. And then once it reloads, just go ahead and load up Minecraft. And then just wait. Bear it back again. And then, so once it's loaded up, it's just about loaded up. Oh wait, I forgot how long the explanation is. Oh, I won't do it again. Okay. So then... Alright, there we go. Not started. So then what you want to do is go to Skins. And so PvP Warriors was actually Bomb Settlers 1 for some reason. So, it goes Bomb Settlers 1. Not go over. Jeez, hard to... Where is it? Okay, there it is. Once again, then they go pro by different colors. My skin, and whatever skin you did, should be somewhere in here. If not, watch the tutorial again and make sure you did everything right. If it still doesn't work, then ask for help. Don't ask for help if you haven't watched this video yet. Okay, so there we go. That's how you get 3DS custom skins for Minecraft Nintendo 3DS Edition 1.4 current version. Not sure how well this works on multiplayer if Screen-O-Matic sucks, as you can tell it's my 3DS. But anyway, like I was saying, you can go into the game and you should have 9 your skin. If you don't, go ahead and check the watch the video again, and if it still doesn't work, then you can ask for help. Don't ask for help unless you've watched the video, because then that's wasting my time. So yeah. There we go. I had better stuff to say, but then the freaking Screen-O-Matic sucks, so it cut out. But anyway, I'll see you guys next time. Bye.